Welcome all. Last time I did Cloak and Dagger, and before that I did the Elemental Imperative and the Tiberium Strain. I'd like to note that at this point we've more or less made through half of these Covert Operation missions, and we're basically also in the missions where it's less based on base orientation and more tactical unit and other stuff. You're basically making use of the game outside base and base operations to win, so to speak. And now Ground Zero's next, let's do it. We start off with a Temple of Nod, it's going to launch a nuke. Because, you know, we love our nukes. Nod has launched a missile, which is aimed at the Global Peace Conference. Get the delegates from the conference to the evac point as quickly as possible. Time is critical. Good luck. Alright, so Nod's launched a missile, and we're tasked with stopping them. Now, I'm not really a big fan of this mission. I found that it's, like, really kind of gimmicky. And I kind of would prefer if it made it a little bit different than it was. But whatever. It is what it is. So this is a timed mission. There is no timer, much like in later games of CNC. But there is a timer, and it is going on silently in the background. You come down here first with these guys, and you sort of try and rescue the civilians from the flame troopers and stuff like that. So hopefully I don't get stopped by these guys. I did that wrong, but oh well. So nothing else besides him here. Next is to get this guy over there. So yes, once you get down this far, you'll get some more reinforcements that you can use. It's a very odd mission in that you basically are sort of getting rid of all these little distractions before going to the peace conference, and there's a missile ticking down in the background. Check down over here, I guess. If you do this mission wrong, you'll basically get screwed up. And it's actually one of those missions that you repeat over and over again a little bit. But whatever, it's fun nonetheless. I can't remember how many times I repeat this the first time I played this mission. I was like playing this mission endlessly because, you know, you have a nuke drop and I, you know, lose that way. Or I just can figure out how to get through it. But luckily, this is not my first playthrough, so I have some semblance of what to do. And now we get ourselves a tank. I can't remember if there's anything down here, but let's just send these guys down in that direction, I guess. We'll go down here first, though. Things all rock. It's worth knowing that this is a lot of ridges for a map. It's basically very maze-like. It's nothing terrible, but I mean, the mission is like very maze-like in how it's designed. Now, I might be screwing myself up a little bit taking this extra detour to go down here. See if there's anything else to find over here. But why not? We'll go over here. So yeah, there's nothing else down here. So, once you kill all the stuff threatening the civilians down here, you basically get yourself a tank. You actually need this tank to sort of progress further. And you'll see why. If you charged up here with like your initial three guys, you lose right away, basically. Because there's a flame tank eventually up north they have to deal with. And there's no way infantry will be able to tackle it alone. Alright, once you get rid of all these guys, I'm not sure if there's anything over here, but we'll just visit over here for a moment. I'm being very, want to visit the entire map-ish type of thing here. Ollie, this is actually a really interesting mission. Other than the fact they have to play it over and over again. Because you'll be like going, trying to find a correct path to get up here. It's like, oh, you have to go this way, so I have to go that way. There's some Tiberium over here, but it's nothing really too threatening. You can just run past this Tiberium more or less at any time of the game. It doesn't grow fast enough to really be a threat. With the Tiberium, it does, you know, expand in this mission, but the problem with it is that by the time it expands like where it's covering the entire area there, the nuke's already dropped. So rig's here. Now this is really dangerous sort of running around with these guys in front, the infantry. I really should be having a tank push ahead. So what we're going to do is we're going to have these guys just get over here. And apparently I'm lagging a little bit, so it might be a good time to stop and let my computer catch up. Alright, my computer's caught up at this point, so let's resume the mission. I'm going to have the medium tank here go first, because there's a flame tank, as I said, up ahead. And if you charge up ahead of the infantry, you lose them. I don't want to lose my infantry, so we're going to have the medium tank absorb the hits, obviously. And there it is. or is gonna, you know, have the Grenadiers sort of help. And once you kill him, you get yourself a Humvee. Yes, because Humvees are fast and they'll be able to catch up a little bit. Now, I think at this point they're sort of being helpful if you try and give you a little bit of an idea of where to go with the road. So I'm pretty sure that's the way down here if you go. Could be wrong though. And I am indeed wrong, so this is the way that we have to go up here. And we apparently have a buggy to worry about. I guess the Humvee sort of distracted him there, which is good. What's happening over here? Just a little bit of Tiberium. Don't worry about that. I think over here we'll actually see the peace conference, but... we'll get there when we get there. Whoa, there's Tiberium here. Alright, I think we can have these guys go up here. And yeah, they can just wander around up. Another situation where you can just wander past the Tiberium. It's not really a big threat to you. Oh, it looks very useful. That civilian running that way. And here we are, we've made it to the Peace Center. Yes, yes. Get these guys immediately outside of the Delegate Center right away. Don't waste time, because, you know, the nuke will hit. Yes, sir. Mobius is all over the place, you know. They're multiplying in these days. I think once you move them outside of this area, you just don't really worry about them getting nuked. But a nuke will eventually drop. At this point, it's more or less a cakewalk, I think, to beat the mission. You have more than enough troops to deal with where Nott has left. Just make sure these guys don't get noticed by guys. Up, there's Nuke! And knocks out all those. Apparently I got a civilian out of that. All enough, that's extra troops. so we'll make use of them. Apparently I had reinforcements some time ago. Once you've basically gotten this fire though, you mean, as I said, it's a cakewalk, you just basically... Basically, you know, taking your time to get through all this. Oh, we got flame tanks coming. Move these guys up here. Is that flame tank going to come for me? I do not know. I think they sit over here, though. You going for him? Yeah, that's where he's going. Oddly enough, I can probably send this guy to be an ass to the flame tank a little bit here. Are you going for me or are you going for civilians still? You guys have almost made over here. I think on the GDI's side, this is actually my favorite mission for them. Even though you have to repeat the mission quite a few times, the sort of elements that are in it, like you're basically fighting off against Nod's evilness in this mission, so to speak. It's a lot different than, you know, a lot of the campaign missions or the other missions in the covert operations. Okay, these guys have more or less caught up. These guys are gonna just come in and we're gonna whomp the flame tank from behind with these guys, but this guy distracts them. I mean, your tank's still taking lots of damage, but. At this point, everyone's caught up. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. Morning. Okay. And here's my groups. We got ourselves a tank, we got ourselves a few infantry, and we got a couple of Humvees.
Yes, sir.
I don't think you get any more units after this point, by the way. Once you get this far, generally there isn't anything else coming, I don't think. Alright, this guy has civilian going down here. This looks like a promising route. Might be the only route, actually. Nope, it's not the only route. There's another route over here. And I guess this guy's sort of showing us the way to get by some Nod's forces. There's probably a blockade somewhere. The only thing that would make this mission better, I think, would be an APC. If an APC had dropped, the Mobus is inside. Well, I guess I'm wrong.
Roger.
That's a ridge.
Hello?
That'll happen this mission. This game lost. Increase the game speed until everyone catches up. I think that for this mission, you only need one Mobius to survive. If one of them dies, or two of them dies, it's fine. Though you probably shouldn't have him dying. I can't remember though. Alright, there's my forces gathered again. I really should be exploring at this point with the Humvees, just in case there's anything that could stopgap myself, so to speak. Oh, one of those guys died. And get these guys down here, past the Tiberium. Looks like a little bit is growing there. Can't really tell though. Alright, so let's just get this underway. We're going to take these guys to explore the rest of the way down to wherever this is they have to go. So we got like a buggy down here, for sure. along with whatever else is down here. Okay, there's a bunch of these guys. We'll send the grenadiers to finish them off. I'll only have this guy go, I guess, for a moment. Okay, that's just a doodad. Looks like we're gonna advance over here a little bit. Whoa! Don't want these guys switching me. Send in these. Ooh! Well, I killed that tank, I guess. Another flame tank. Shoot, this is bad. I need you to distract everyone else to run. Alright, that was bad, but not horrible. One moment, we're being someone at the door downstairs. Alright, so mail came. So we're getting to the end of this road, so to speak. Yes, sir. Bring you guys there. You know, I might have been able to punch my way through that trees right there. Just a little bit of observation there. Move these guys this way. Looks like I've almost made to where... Whoopsie. Flame troopers. Very dangerous. Probably the most dangerous thing in this mission is flame tanks and stuff like that. Just because you have so many infantry and so little armor. I have one heavy armored unit and it's taking such a beating already. Alright, there's that there. And then there's all this stuff over here. Move these guys this way. Just gonna harass these guys with the Humvees. Yes, sir. Alright. At this point, I think it's just a rush job. All that's left is this buggy pretty much over here, I think, so... Let's just clear out what's left and get my guys to a drop point. Anything left to worry about? Don't think so. Well, nothing important at least. So that's basically this mission, Ground Zero. You're basically taking these three guys from their peace conference down to here. Probably should not have forces to worry about, but nothing too severe. Let's take these injured guys out. I'm gonna be cheeky here, just drop these guys in. Because I can. And yeah, all you need to do is get one in there and it flies off. A very, very simple mission, so to speak, but you do need to play it, I think, more than once to beat it. Most of the time.
Mission accomplished.
The Hawk and Scorpion. Or is it the Eagle and Scorpion? Never really guessed as to what the bird was for GDI. Took me 41 minutes to beat that one, so that's, probably longer than most other, you know, missions of that type, where you're not really building a base or anything. That's why I kind of like this mission. It is, you know, fairly involved to beat. But it's not boring in any way. You don't have to go do something cheesy, like try and find stuff in the Tiberian Strain, for example. You don't have to, you have to be on your toes for all the stuff that comes at you. But for the most part, it is a fun mission. And I got the high score. I love it. So that was Ground Zero, hope you enjoyed, and next time we'll be going to Hostile Takeover. I think once you get down to Hostile Takeover and Under CNC, Twist of Fate and Blindside, these are more base type of missions again, but they're not as heavily laid out to say Infiltrate, Hell's Fury, Blackout, you know, all the other stuff. So take care, next time we'll see what's happening.